If you say, Bhanu, if you say smart objectives, yes, then at the same time you need to know who this person is. Like, this person can be a psychic person, this person can be a semi-psychic person, that person can be normal or abnormal. So when you are setting goals, when you say realistic, realistic to that particular person. Mm-hmm. Therefore, goal setting has to be always done with clear understanding and deeper level of understanding. Then it can be smart. Merely because you say smart goals, like we know, there was a specific measurable, attainable, relevant, trackable and all that. There are more than that also when you come to goal setting, some other rules like PCC, Priva rule of goal setting, etc. So of course, if you follow these rules of goal setting and somebody set the goals according to those, mm-hmm. then those are achievable. Goals have to be always achievable.
All right. How far can a person change his attitude or behavior in order to suit the real world?
That's a real serious question, Bhanu, you're asking. A person can change the attitude as far as you have a need to change it. If somebody doesn't want to change it, you cannot change it. The reason is your attitude is based inside your brain, and people's behavior, anybody's behavior, is created with the mental states that person has. Mental states are created with the beliefs, the values, memories of that particular person. If that person's beliefs and his memories, those are called brain filters, mm-hmm. then if you, I would try to change a person's behavior, but then my talk, my information that I give you or the particular person will go clash with the attitude, beliefs, then memories, values of that particular person. So if that person is not ready to change, till that person is ready, mm-hmm. it will be very difficult for him to change his behavior, because what I am trying to give, he has his internal brain filters which come and clash with my idea, and then if I am not forceful enough to give something new to his brain, then his mental state won't change. That means his behavior would not change.
So in other words, there is no mutual understanding, is it?
When I say mutual understanding, there is no mm-hmm. filtering through the brain filters to get to the mental state. That is why, like, we trainers learn various methodologies how to go
in to get through that.
To get through that, exact word is to get through that, those filters, and then influence that person, then to create a new mental state. Because you have a new mental state, then you can create a new behavior state. Then with the new behavior state, you get new results in life.
Okay, so is this a good way of overcoming depression?
When you say depression...
And it's an overloaded word.
It's an overloaded word, because as a doctor treating mental patients, I should say you have to categorize people into psychic, psychotic, then neurotic, psychologically sick, and... like semi-levels, then not so psychologically sick, but then having psychological defects, psychological disorders, so various categories. Therefore, when you say that, when you talk about goal setting or destiny or getting results, etc., we have to clearly understand that a psychologically sick person, mm-hmm. mentally sick person, has to be treated with with medicines or treatments or prescriptions which are suitable to that person. It's not training or it's not teaching that can help that person. We have to look at that person as...
And I guess it depends from person to person.
Person, because you asked about the depression.
Yeah.
Depression, immediately when you say, it's not a normal person. Yeah. It's depressed. Therefore, we have to go deeper into his problem, mm-hmm. and then see whether you can follow this model and solve. Of course, this model will work, but then before that, you have to get that person out of depression.
Yeah.
Sometimes some people are deeply depressed, but not psychologically seriously sick or psychological patient, but depressed. Asking three questions, if we can enhance that person's cognition means the level of understanding, suddenly that person comes out of depression. So it can happen, but seriously mentally sick, mental patient, it will not be possible. But of course, depends on the level.
All right. It's a huge answer to process, actually, but it takes time, and it's a very thoughtful commitment, I think, which has to be given to all the people out there as well. So tell us a little bit more about the training and consultations that you've undergone in psychology management, leadership, personality, various segments, various industries that you've taken part. Anything that you would like to share on with us on the show?
I'm a little bit of a crazy person in that way when you ask me that question, because I can't be satisfied by doing one thing. Because when I learn one methodology or one thing, mm-hmm. and then I go and try to apply it on people, I see a person who doesn't answer to that model or methodology that I follow. I see, what's your problem? Then I try to follow the tool or the technique that I have learned. Then that doesn't work on him. Then I spend any amount of money, I go finding whether there is any other methodology which I can solve this problem easily. Then I learn some other thing. In that process, I have learned neuro-linguistic programming methodologies and mind-muscle vibration therapy models, brain dynamic models and brain waves, alpha dynamics, various things like Reiki you mentioned earlier, then yoga therapy, naturopathy, various places in the world, various countries at different times. Till to date, all the last 2 decades, I have been doing this. So it is a very, very long topic
list
to talk about. Yes,
exactly.
List, yes.
On a final note, what's the message that you would like to encode to all the fans out there and the audience as well, and the Destiny Day, the location, the time and the dates and the information that you would like to pass?
Destiny Day, last week we had one at Hilton, and we had a lot of people who turned up there. Then there were some other people who got to know about it last minute, couldn't join there. Therefore, we decided to have one immediately this week, 13th October.
13th of October, mark your calendars. 13th, yes.
13th of October, mm-hmm. At Hilton, mm-hmm. English medium, purely for English medium people, that one. Mm-hmm. Then we have Destiny Day, single medium, on the 16th of October, again at our auditorium, Wisdom Train Auditorium, Nugegoda. On Destiny Day, what I am doing is, I teach people through 21 special things. You ask me what subjects I have learned. I have inculcated all the subjects into that Destiny Day. I teach through 21 techniques to identify what problems you have, then how you created the problems, then where you want to be in the future, and then what actions you need to take today to go where you want to go, to be the person you want to be, to have what you want to have in the future. Then, on this particular day, you will also learn that if you want to have a change in your life, change in your destiny, you have to take massive action about your life. At the same time, you will also learn, I will also teach that you are the creator of your own destiny, nobody else. And you are responsible for your own growth, nobody else. And when you learn that, it is very simple for you to understand that it is in here, it is in here. At the same time, when you learn that, you will be much more powerful, and you will suddenly take something from inside to feel that, oh, I can be bigger than this. My destiny is somewhere else, not here. And this is relevant for students, relevant for adults who are doing business, relevant for somebody who is aiming at getting the next job promotion in the job that they are doing, relevant for anybody who wants to have a better life.
It's a common goal, and anyone can achieve it if they really want.
Exactly.
You can always register as well. The hotline number for this event is 011-401-301 or 011-77-01-701. Wisdom Trainer he is, and the Kumar International is the organization name, if I'm going to call it. Thank you so much for making it to the studios on Good Morning Sri Lanka. It's been a terrific blast for all of us. Unfortunately, there's a time that we all have for the show. We'll be back as well tomorrow with something exciting as well on Good Morning Sri Lanka. Like our fan page as well, www.facebook.com/Good Morning Sri Lanka. Good day, everyone.